By now, we've all heard about the disaster at the skilled nursing facility in Hollywood, Florida, where 8 residents died from the heat after Hurricane Irma. It never should have happened, and we all have to wonder what the staff was thinking when inside temperatures soared and vital signs hit the danger zone. What we should have expected is politicians, regulators, and other groups demanding more staffing so something like this does not happen again. While I agree that this should never happen again, I don't agree that staffing levels should be reevaluated as a result of one horrible event. And the one thing that none of these politicians bring up is, who will pay for any of these changes, if any come? Florida just filed for an emergency rule requiring that both assisted living and skilled nursing facilities file a plan within 60 days to acquire a generator that can keep the building's air temperature at 80 degrees for 4 days. While that makes sense, and we assume they already had them, generators alone will not solve the problem, especially if you are 6 feet underwater or have no roof. Please, let's not re-examine an entire sector because of one bad apple. Skilled nursing owners have enough headwinds to deal with.